Hello, my name is Steven, and you're watching another episode of Crossroads Rebuild. Thank you for joining me today. If you haven't already subscribed, why don't you go ahead and take care of that right now. In today's episode, it is going to be a mega update. I'm going to get you updated on what I've been up to, some new things going on here in my Crossroads Rebuild life, and then also the much anticipated update on the BMW that I've been promising for a while. Let's get started. So the first thing you might notice is that I am no longer in my driveway at the house. This is a new location, and the reason for that is I actually have a shop now, sort of. I have a friend who's got some extra garage space that he's letting me rent from him, and I haven't finished setting it up yet, but I am starting to move some things in. So rather than try to describe it for you, let me give you a quick tour of the new shop. So the shop is situated a few miles from my house out in the beautiful Indiana countryside. He's got a nice piece of property here. I apologize that things look kind of cluttered right now, but that's because I'm still moving in and we're still transitioning over from him using this as a personal space to me now using it as a shop. As you can see, I got the lift moved in. You might recognize that from some social media posts a few months ago, but I got this moved in. I'm excited to be able to start using it in my rebuild projects. Outside the shop, there is a huge parking area with plenty of space for me to park vehicles that I'm working on. He wants me to be able to have this space to park as many vehicles as I'd like. As you can see, it's got quite a few vehicles in it right now. A few of those are his that are being moved out, but several of those are mine. They're projects that I'll be working on here coming soon. And he also has several really cool toys sitting out. I have no idea what year this old Jeep is, but man, I would love to get my hands on this to do as a rebuild project. It actually belongs to his brother. It's a project intended for his brother to do with his grandson. But man, if that ever falls through, I told him, just let me know. I'd love to have this Jeep to work on. So the first project I'd like to introduce you to is this 2000 Toyota Camry. This car belongs to a friend of mine, and the reason I'm working on it is because it has an engine that's just about shot. The car only has about 150,000 miles on it, but very uncommon to Toyotas, this particular engine has developed quite a significant rod knock and is on its last leg. The plan for this car is actually to do an engine swap. While it may not make sense to most of you to spend the time and effort on a car like this to do an engine swap, the reason we're going to do that is because this car has sentimental value to my friend. And the car's just been sitting in his driveway now for a little while with this bad engine. And his daughter is getting ready to start driving. She just started driver's ed, and he would like to give this car to her as her first car. So we're gonna go ahead and do an engine swap on this car and give it a new lease on life so that his daughter can enjoy it as her first car. The donor car for this engine swap is a 2001 Camry that I picked up at IAA here in Indianapolis. This car is a salvage title. However, it's only got about 84,000 miles on it. Went out and took a look at it, got the engine started, and it just runs butter smooth as you would typically expect of an older Toyota. So this car is going to be used as an engine donor and maybe a couple of other parts for my buddy's car. But this project will be an interesting one because I've never done an engine swap before, done some research on it, and honestly it doesn't look that difficult as far as this car is concerned, but I guess we'll find out. I have a way of underestimating these things, so I may find that it's a lot harder than I expected. But in any case, we're gonna get into it and I'm gonna bring you guys along for the process on doing my first ever engine swap. So the next project I'd like to introduce to you is the BMW you probably saw earlier as I was giving a walkthrough of the shop. This is a 1998 BMW 328i convertible. That'd be an E36 chassis to those who pay attention to such things. And this car has a clean title. Yes, a clean title, and I am excited about it. I picked up this little BMW at IAA here in Indianapolis for just a few hundred dollars. And while it is absolutely filthy and kind of crusty around the edges here and there, it has a ton of potential. I'm excited about diving into this car and kind of giving it a new lease on life, kind of bringing it back and being able to enjoy this car. I plan to hang on to it for a little while. While the body of this BMW is actually in pretty good shape, it obviously has a few things like these broken windows that I'm gonna have to take care of right away. I'm assuming this is vandalism of some sort, or maybe they got broken at the IAA lot. But in any case, I'm gonna have to get those fixed right away so that I can keep this car outside without it getting rained into. I've also got an obvious problem here with the roof. The roof is going to have to be replaced. I'm a little intimidated by the idea of replacing a convertible top, but I've talked to several people and done some reading, and everybody assures me that it's not as hard as I imagine. So that'll be one of the things that we'll get into, and of course document the whole process along the way. I'm planning on doing an episode here in the very near future on everything that is broken and needing a little love on this BMW. I'll also give you an idea of what I've spent on the car, as well as what I plan to start working on first. So stay tuned for that. So the last update I'd like to give to you is on the 2006 E90 BMW 330 Xi. As you know, we got the suspension fixed up and the car is running and driving beautifully. And so now it is in my buddy's shop for the body work. He was able to get that door open and taken off so he could examine the damage a little closer. And we determined that the best course of action was to go ahead and cut out the bad metal and weld in new. So the first thing we did was get the interior stripped down so we don't damage it at any point along the process of cutting metal or welding metal. And got all of that out of there, and then I went down to a place on the south side of Indy called Brickyard Imports. It is a gigantic wrecking yard of all import cars. You'll find your European brands, Japanese, even a few Korean cars, but you just won't find any American cars. In any case, they've got a wide selection of BMWs. And I was able to find a nice donor car that was totaled, but the corner that we needed, that passenger side rear quarter panel and the dog leg there, was totally undamaged. So I was able to buy a quarter cut off of that car and bring it back and use that to weld into my BMW. So I apologize that this project is taking a while. My buddy's doing his best to keep the cost down, and so he's working on it between other projects. But we are making progress, and I hope to have that car finished up and ready to do a final reveal for you guys very soon. Thank you for watching another episode of Crossroads Rebuild. I'm excited to get into these new projects. I've got the Camry project with the first time ever doing an engine swap. I've got the BMW E36 project that I'm excited to get going. Excited that that's a clean title car that I can hang on to for a while. So stay tuned for both of those projects. Also, you'll be seeing progress here around the shop as I get it organized, I get it cleaned up, and I get it set up to actually start doing work in. Before I end this video, I also need to take a moment to thank BMW Fanatic on YouTube and FCP Euro. FCP Euro is a company that provides high quality parts for all sorts of European makes and models, and they provide a lifetime guarantee on everything they sell. BMW Fanatic partnered with FCP Euro to do a $500 gift card giveaway, and I was selected as the winner of that drawing. So I am so thankful to both of them for this gift of $500, and this will go a long way toward buying parts for my new E36 BMW project, as well as some parts for the E90 that we're still finishing up. So thank you very much, and go support them by visiting his channel and shopping at fcpeuro.com. I'll drop a link in the subscription below.
Thank you for watching again. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and do so, and then click that bell so you can be notified each time I upload a new episode. Stay tuned for these upcoming project videos, and also go ahead and find me on social media. I'm on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Find me there. I'll have that information down here below. Like, comment, and subscribe on this video, and we'll catch you in the next one.